everyone, it's Nadia from Yarn Utopia. Today we are going to make this chunky yarn wavy hat today. This is a really cool pattern and it gives a wavy effect on the hat, which is really cool. And we're going to be working with a pom and we are just going to be having such a great time with our chunky yarn. The supplies we need today are all Lion brand yarns. I have the labels all here. Let me grab this out real quick. So we have Lion brand yarn, Hometown USA types of yarn. And I have three colors. You will need three skeins of yarn. Now, if you do not want to use multiple colors, you can use one color, solid color, or as many colors as you want, really. And the three colors that I have chosen to use today are San Diego Navy, Billings Chocolate, and Los Angeles Tan. So make sure you get those colors. Also, the size yarn to use, these are super bulky, size 6. Okay. So you can see the labels here. Super bulky, size 6. These are 81 yards each, so you will need three skeins of yarn of the 81 yards. These are 5-ounce skeins, so make sure you do get 5-ounce skeins. And you will be using, I mean, this is all I have left, so scraps left. So make sure that you get three skeins of yarn to use during this project. The size hook we are going to use today is a size N hook, which is 9 millimeters, so make sure you have that handy. You could do this with a 10 millimeter hook as well. That would be totally fine. We're also going to need a scissors and a yarn needle to cut our yarn and sew in our ends, so make sure you have that as well. Now we are going to be making a pom today. Toward the end of this video, I show how to make a pom. If you have a pom maker, you can use that. Otherwise, I just went old school and cut some cardboard and used the pieces of cardboard just like this. And I'll show you how to do that, or I tell you how to do it. I don't cut this on camera because it's very difficult to cut cardboard on camera. So I cut this off camera, but I just used a CD to trace this, and then cut a hole in the middle, cut a slit down the side, and then I show you how to wrap the yarn and how to complete your pom. So we're working with this fabulous pom today. And this is all the supplies we need. Like I said, make sure you have three skeins of yarn. So they're 81 yards each, 5-ounce skeins, super bulky yarn. I don't really have a pattern or, a hat like this that has a thinner type of yarn, you know, a worsted weight or anything. But make sure you check out the links in the description. I will have the written pattern for this on my blog. The link to my blog will be in the description of this video. Also, check out the link to my Facebook. Join me on Facebook and share your work. If you make this hat, make sure to share your work. I would love to see the colors and creativity that you come up with on making this hat. It was so much fun to make, so I love to see your work on it as well. And also check out my Instagram and Snapchat. On Instagram, make sure to hashtag YarnUtopia or tag me in your photos so I can see your work. And follow me on Snapchat. I'll put my username in the description of this video so you can follow me and see my behind-the-scenes footage and everything. I want to thank our videographer and photographer and editor of this video, Fuad Azmat, my dad, for taking the time out to make this video with us. Make sure to subscribe to my channel here on YouTube and check out my channel. There's a button on the right-hand side of my channel that says support us. Make sure you support us so we can keep bringing you fantastic crochet videos because I love to crochet. So make sure you do that. But without further ado, let's get started on making this fabulous hat. All right, to start out, we're going to start out with the brown, the chocolate color, Billings chocolate. And we have to make a slip knot. So put the short end over the long end, fold that down, and then pull that all the way through like that. And pull tight, insert your hook, and we're ready to go. So for round one, we have to chain 3. So yarn over and pull through 1, 2, and 3. And in the third chain from the hook, we have to put 12 double crochets in here. This whole pattern is in multiples of 12. So the loop that's on your hook never counts as anything. So count 1, 2, and 3. And we're going to yarn over, go into that third chain from the hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over and pull through 2 loops. That's a double crochet. So we have to make 11 more for a total of 12. So again, I'll show you. We're going to yarn over, go into that chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, and pull through 2 loops. Okay, yarn over, go back into that chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here's 5. 6. And you can see that I am crocheting more like in a circular form because we are working in rounds. And also I'm crocheting over the top of my straggler so that can be hidden underneath and sewn in. And I can cut that later. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And if you know how to make the magic circle and then work, you can do that. Work your 12 double crochets in the magic circle. Pull tight. Alright, so I have 12 double crochets in that space. Now we have to slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of this round. We are not going to be slip stitching to this chain up 2 here. And the chain up 2 in this pattern on every row does not count as anything. And I'll remind you as we go along. But just count back 12 here and then insert your hook right into that first double crochet of this round. Yarn over, pull through, and pull through. That's a slip stitch. Okay, so we just closed that up. We finished round 1. Going on to round 2, we want to actually change color. So, I'm sorry. If you were going to work with the same color, that's how you would slip stitch and go on to round 2 by chaining up 2. But I want to change color every round. So, I'm going to show you that again, but changing color. We're going to insert our hook in that first double crochet of the round, get our new color, drop our old color, pick up the new color. I basically just fold it in half around my finger, hook it around the hook, just like that, pull through, and finish that off. Pull all the stragglers tight. And then chain up 2. 1 and 2. Okay? So if you did not change color, just do a regular slip stitch and chain up 2 like I showed you earlier. So now we're with our new color. Now we want to put, for round 2, we want to put 2 double crochet in each stitch around, including the stitch that we just slip stitched to. So this slip stitch and chain up 2, this chain up 2 doesn't count as anything, so we have to put 2 double crochet in this first stitch here. So we're going to yarn over, go into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Okay, we want to put 2 double crochets in each stitch around, so we're going to move this a little over, and we're going to yarn over and go back into that same stitch for a second double crochet. Okay, so we just put 2 double crochets into this first stitch here. Now going on to the next stitch, we're going to put the 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. Okay, again, in the next stitch, we're going to put 2 double crochets. So basically, you just put 2 double crochets in each stitch all the way around. And at the end of this round, you should have 24 double crochets. I'm going to pause for a second here and show you. I'm going to turn this over like this. I'll show you how to cut your stragglers and weave in your ends here. So cut this. And I like to tie my work, the two stragglers, so the new color and the old color, just tie them in a notch. And this is the inside of the hat, so nobody's going to see this. Okay, and now to sew in our ends, we need a yarn needle. Okay, and then we're going to go underneath these stitches. Okay, just like that. And then stretch it out so it's completely hidden underneath there. Okay, so do that for the rest of the project when every time we change color. If you're not changing any colors, don't worry about doing anything like that. Just continue working the pattern. And once I'm finished with round two, by putting two double crochets in each stitch around, I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round three together. Alright, I just finished round two, so I have two double crochets in each stitch around. Now you want to make sure to slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of this round right here, not this chain up two here. So go into this first stitch, and again, if you're not changing color, just yarn over, pull through. But I'm going to change color here to the San Diego blue, pull through and through. Pull all the stragglers tight, drop the old yarn, and chain up two, one and two. Okay, now going on to round three, we're going to put two double crochets in this first stitch, where we just slip stitched and chained up two. We're going to put two double crochets in there, and then one double crochet in the next stitch. And then we're just going to repeat that around. So yarn over, go right into this first stitch here, where we just slip stitched two. And put two double crochets in there. One and two. Okay. Then in the next stitch, we're just going to put one double crochet. Okay. Now on to the next stitch, we're going to put two double crochets in there. One and two. And then in the next stitch, we're just going to put one double crochet. Okay, next stitch, two double crochets, one and two, and the next stitch is just one double crochet. So every other stitch, we're just going to put two double crochets in there. So just continue working this pattern all the way around. At the end of this round, you'll have 36 double crochets, so I'll meet you up and we will go on to round four together. Alright, so I just finished round three, and I have 36 stitches. Now we're going to slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of this round. If you have to count back 36, do so, and we are changing color back to chocolate brown here. Let's see here. This color is Billings Chocolate, so I'm going to attach... We're doing a slip stitch with that. Okay, going on to round four, we want to chain up two. So yarn over, pull through, one and two. All right. Now for round four, we want to put two double crochet in the next stitch and then one double crochet in the next two stitches. And be sure to put your first two double crochets in this first stitch right here where we just attached by doing a slip stitch and a chain up two. So put your two first double crochets in there. So one and two. Okay, two double crochets in there. And then one double crochet in each of the next two stitches. So one in there and one in here. Okay, now we're going to go on and repeat all of that. So in the next stitch, we're going to put two double crochets, one and two. And then we're going to put one double crochet in the next two stitches. Okay, repeat, go two double crochets in this next stitch. and then one double crochet in the next two stitches. Whoops. Come on, yarn. There we go. All right. So just repeat that all the way around. At the end of this round, you'll have your 48 double crochets, and then we are all done increasing. Now, if you wanted to make this a little bit smaller, you could have ended your increases on either round 2 or 3, and then just hopped on up to round 5, the repeat pattern of round 5. But that's totally up to you if you want to make it smaller. Otherwise, just continue working this round, round 4, and do your increases to 48 stitches. And then once we're finished with round 4, I'll meet you up and we will go on to round 5 together to start making the wavy design. All right, this is what it should look like now after round 4. You should have 48 double crochets. So now we're going to change color, slip stitch with our new color. So slip stitch to the first double crochet of this round, not the chain of 2. So go into the first double crochet, hook on the new color, or if you're not changing color, just slip stitch and chain up 2, but hook your new color if you are changing color. Okay, for a slip stitch, and then chain up 2, 1 and 2, and now we're going to start making the wavy design. So on this round, in the first stitch here where we just slip stitch 2, we're going to put 3 double crochets. So yarn over, go into the stitch for 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3. And now we're just going to put one regular double crochet in the next 4 stitches. So in the next stitch here, we're just going to put 1 and 1 in the next and 1 in the next and 1 in the next. Okay, now we are going to make a double crochet 3 together. So double crocheting these 3 stitches into 1 stitch. Okay, so yarn over. I'll show you how to do this. Yarn over, go into this first stitch. Yarn over, pull that through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Hold it. You have 2 loops on your hook. We're going to yarn over, go into the next stitch. Yarn over, pull that through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Okay, you have 3 loops left on your hook. We're going to yarn over, go into the next stitch. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. So now you have 4 loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over and pull through all 4 of those loops. Okay, so we just decreased 3 stitches into 1. A double crochet 3 together. Okay, now in the next 4 stitches, we're just going to put 1 regular double crochet. So yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. That was 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we just put 1 double crochet in the next 4 stitches. Now we're going to do an increase, or I'm sorry, not an increase, but we're going to put 3 double crochets in this next stitch, which makes it seem like an increase. So go into this next stitch by yarning over, going in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and we have to make 3 double crochets in that same stitch. So that was 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so 3 double crochets in that next stitch right there. Now, in the next 4 stitches, we are just going to put 1 double crochet in each of those. So 1 in there, 1 in there, 1 in there, and 1 in there. Now we have to do a double crochet 3 together again. Okay, so I'll show you how to do that again. Yarn over, go into this next stitch here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops. Then you have four loops on your hook. You'll yarn over and pull through all four of those loops. Okay, that's double crochet three together. Now we're going to double crochet one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. So one, two, three, and four. And in the next stitch, we're going to put three double crochets in there. So one, two, and three. Okay, so three of those, three double crochets in that same stitch together. Now we're going to just put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. Okay, so one in there, one in there, one in there, and one in there. Okay, now we have to do our decrease, so our double crochet three together. Yarn over, go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, and pull through all four loops on your hook, and then put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. One, two, three, and four. Now in this next stitch, we're going to put three double crochets all in that same stitch. So one, two, and three. And then put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. So one, two, three, and four. And now in this next stitch, we're almost done with this round, we are going to do our double crochet three together. So yarn over, go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, and pull through all four loops on your hook, and put one double crochet in each of the last four stitches on this round. One, two, three, and four. Okay, so that was round five. And we are going to slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of this round right here. And we are changing our color. Slip stitch, pull through and through. Okay, now chain up two, one and two. Going on to round six, we are going to put one double crochet in the first stitch where we just attached two. So put one double crochet in there. Okay, and now you can see this grouping of three here, one, two, three. We just put a double crochet in that first one. Always in the middle one of these, we are going to put three double crochets in there. Okay, so we are at the middle there, so we're going to put three double crochets right in there. So one, two, three. Then we are going to put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. So one, two, 3 and 4. And now you can see here there's our double crochet decrease, our double crochet 3 together, and then there's a stitch on each side of it. We are going to do a double crochet 3 together over these 3 stitches. So yarn over, go into this next stitch here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, which should be your decrease from the previous round, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, then yarn over and pull through all 4 of the loops on your hook, and then put 1 regular double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Okay, so we're just going to repeat that sequence all the way around. So in the next stitch, we have to increase by putting 3 double crochets in that same stitch. 1, 2, and 3. Then put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now we have to decrease. And you can see here our double crochet 3 together from the previous round is right in the middle there. So yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, and pull through all 4 loops on your hook. And then put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now we are at that middle stitch right there, those grouping of 3 double crochets, so you know to increase, so put 3 double crochets in that middle stitch there. 1, 2, and 3. And then put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now we are going to decrease. So do a double crochet 3 together. I'm sure you know by now, we've been doing quite a few of those. So I'm just going to go a little faster here. Okay, and then put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we have to put 3 double crochets in the next stitch. 1, 2, and 3. And then put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we're going to make a decrease, double crochet 3 together. Okay, and then just put 1 double crochet in the last 3 stitches. So 1, 1, and 1. And then slip stitch to the first double crochet of this round with our new color. Oops, I didn't cut it from previous round. Okay, so loop that around. And then pull it through and through for a slip stitch. Alright, going on to round number 7, we are going to chain up 2, 1 and 2, and it says to put 1 double crochet in the first 2 stitches, so yarn over, go right into the same stitch that we just slip stitched into for 1 double crochet, and then 1 double crochet in the next stitch. And then in this next stitch, we're going to put 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And then we're just going to repeat our pattern by putting one double crochet in the next, each of the next 4 stitches, and then doing our double crochet 3 together, and then one double crochet in the next 4 stitches, and then repeat with our 3 double crochets in the same stitch. Okay, so now I'm doing my double crochet decrease 3 together here. Okay, so this round is, we had to put the one double crochet in the first 2 stitches, but then we did the 3 double crochets in the next stitch, one double crochet in the next 4 stitches, double crochet 3 together, then put one double crochet in the next 4 stitches, and then repeat by putting the 3 double crochets together in the next stitch, and then you get it. So just do that all the way around, and at the end of this round, I'll meet you up when I'm finishing this round, because you will end this round with one double crochet in the last 2 stitches this time. So I'll meet you up when we are finishing round 7 and going on to round 8. Alright, so I just finished round 7 here, so we had to do the double crochet 3 together, and then put one double crochet in the last 2 stitches. So, 1 and 1. Okay, because these will come together, so it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4. Slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of that round, and we're changing colors, so I need to get my tan out here. Slip stitch, and then chain up 2, 1 and 2, okay. And now going on to round 8, we want to put one double crochet in the first 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3. So put one double crochet in the first 3 stitches there. The first stitch will go into that same one where you slip stitched into, right there. And then 1 and 1. Okay, and now we're to the point where we are in the middle stitch of the group 3 double crochets from the previous round. So we're going to put 3 double crochets in that stitch. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, then put one double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Okay, and then we're going to do a double crochet 3 together decrease here. Whoopsie here. There we go. So double crochet 3 together, because now we're over these 3 stitches. This is our double crochet 3 together from the previous round, and then the one before it and the one after it. We will crochet all 3 of these stitches together. Okay, then put one double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. And then repeat our pattern. So put 3 double crochets in the next stitch. 1, 2, and 3. And then put one double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. And then do a double crochet 3 together. And then put one double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Okay, and then put 3 double crochets in the next stitch. and then one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. And our double crochet three together. Okay, and one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. Okay, and three double crochets in the next stitch. And one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. And a double crochet three together. And put one double crochet in the last stitch. Okay. Then slip stitch to the beginning double crochet of this round. Change color if you are changing colors by doing a slip stitch like that. And then chain up two, one and two. Now we are going to put one double crochet in the first four stitches. So one double crochet in here. That's the same stitch that we slip stitched into and chained up two in. So put one in there. One double crochet in the first four stitches. So one, two, three, and four. And then we're repeating our pattern that we've been doing. So three double crochets in this top stitch here. One, two, and three. And then one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. One, two, three, and four. Then do a double crochet three together. And then put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches, and then repeat the three double crochets in the next stitch, then one double crochet in the next four stitches, then a double crochet three together, then one double crochet in the next four stitches, then three double crochets in that next stitch. You know the pattern now. So I'm going to leave you to do that for the rest of this round, and I'll meet you up and we'll go on to finishing our hat. Okay, so for round nine, you want to end with the double crochet three together. Okay, so I'm just going to do that real quick. And then we are done with the hat part. Now we want to work on the ear flaps. So slip stitch to the beginning. Let's see, I need dark brown here. Okay, and we're going to work on the ear flaps now. So for the ear flaps, we need to chain two, one and two. And now we're going to be working with half double crochets. So we want to half double crochet in the first 10 stitches. So yarn over, go into this first stitch where we just slip stitch to. Yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three of the loops on your hook. Okay, that's a half double crochet. And we are going to put a half double crochet in the first 10 stitches. So that was one, this is two. Yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. That is three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, and nine, and ten. Okay? Now we want to chain two, one and two, turn our work, so we're looking at the inside of the hat. I'm going to tie this real quick. Okay, now we're going to do a decrease, a half double crochet two together over these first two stitches. So yarn over, go into the first stitch, yarn over, pull through, go directly into the next stitch, yarn over, pull that through, yarn over, and pull through all four loops on your hook. That's a half double crochet two together. Now, just half double crochet into each of the next six stitches. So one, two, three, four, five, and six. And you should have two stitches left. And we are going to half double crochet two together on those two. So yarn over, go into that stitch, yarn over, pull through. Go into the next stitch, our very last stitch on this row, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all four loops on your hook, chain up two, one and two, turn your work. So now we're looking at the outside of the hat, and on this row we are just going to be doing a regular half double crochet in each stitch across. So just a regular half double crochet in each stitch, that'll give us 8 half double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, then chain up two, one and two, turn your work so you're looking at the inside of the hat, and now we are going to half double crochet two together over these first two here. Okay, and then we're going to do a regular half double crochet in the middle four stitches. So one, two, three, and four, and then you should have two stitches left on this row, and we're going to half double crochet those two together. Okay, just like that. So you should have six stitches on this row. Chain two, one and two, turn your work, and now we are going to just do one half double crochet in each stitch across, for a total of six half double crochets on this row. Okay, and then chain up two and turn your work. And we're going to half double crochet two together, and then do a regular half double crochet in the middle two stitches. And then once you have two stitches left on this row, you can half double crochet those two together. Okay, now at this point, fasten off. So what I like to do is just chain up one, cut my yarn, and then pull that all the way through and pull tight. I am going to weave in that end, and then we will make the other ear flap. All right, so I just weaved in my end here. This is what our first ear flap looks like. Now turn your hat like this, upside down here, And we are going to skip 15 stitches across this way here, going toward the left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And then go into the 16th stitch right there. And that is where we're going to start our next ear flap. So loop your yarn around your hook and pull that through. Then chain up two, one and two. And I'm going to do this one a little bit faster because I just showed you how to do the first ear flap. So make sure to half double crochet in these first 10 stitches, including the stitch that we just attached to. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And you notice I was crocheting over my straggler, so it is hidden completely. Now chain 2, turn your work so you're looking at the inside of the hat. Half double crochets. Half double crochet 2 together on these first 2 here. And then half double crochet in the next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then you should have 2 stitches left, so we're going to half double crochet those 2 together. Okay, then chain 2, turn your work, and half double crochet across. So we're just repeating what we did for the first ear flap, but we're working on the second ear flap now. So just half double crochet across this row. So you should have 8 half double crochets. Okay, then chain 2, 1 and 2, turn your work. We are going to half double crochet 2 together. And then put a regular half double crochet in the middle 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then put 1 half double crochet 2 together on those last 2 stitches there. Alright, then chain 2, 1 and 2. Turn your work. Looking at the outside of our hat, we are going to half double crochet across for a total of 6 half double crochets. Okay, then chain 2, turn your work. And now we are going to half double crochet 2 together, and then do a regular half double crochet in the next 2 stitches, and then half double crochet those last 2 stitches together. And now on our other ear flap we just fastened off, but we want to chain 1 and turn our work. And now we're going to continue to single crochet around our whole hat. Okay, so insert your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. That's a single crochet. So we are just going to single crochet around this entire hat, go across this row, and then go down the side of the ear flap. Basically, wherever your hook fits is where you should single crochet, just like this. Insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, two loops. Okay, so basically wherever it fits is where you should single crochet down the side of this. Okay, and then once we get to this part of the hat, we can just single crochet in each stitch on this last row here. Just like that. And then just work around the next ear flap and around the other side of the hat. And I'll meet you up when I am back to the this ear flap that we were just working on. And I'll show you how to fasten off, and we will make the tassels and the pom. All right, so I just came back around and I single crocheted around my entire hat. To fasten off, we're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet of this round. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through and through, okay, for a slip stitch. And then to fasten off, I like to chain one and then cut my yarn and pull that all the way through and pull tight. And you can even reinforce it with a knot if you'd like. Otherwise, just sew in this end here with your yarn needle and just go underneath some of these stitches here. And then stretch it out, pulling it so that it is all hidden underneath. Cut off any extras. Hide it that away. And there is our hat. Okay, now you can see the seam here. That's the back of our hat, so it ends here. So this is the back side. So this is the front of our hat. Okay, so this is what our hat looks like so far. Now we are going to make a pom to go on the top, and then we are going to do tassels down each side of the ear flaps. So get the color that you want for the pom. Mine is going to be dark blue, so I'm going to set this aside. To make a pom, what I actually ended up doing is getting old school and cutting pieces of cardboard and just taking a CD and tracing it and then cutting a hole in the middle. That's basically what I did, and just take two of these and put them together like this. There are pom makers. For those of you who are more expert at this, you get a pom maker and make a pom using one of those. But for us old school crocheters and pom makers, just get two pieces of cardboard, cut them out looking like this. Like I said, it's about the size of a compact disc, CD, so you can trace one or something similar and then cut a hole in the middle. And then I also cut a slit down the side for space to get my yarn through there. So how we do that is get our yarn ready here, and we're going to start on one side and work our way around this. So go like this, so you have it out in the back there, and hold it with your finger, and then wrap this in such a way around this piece, okay, around your straggler there, so it kind of X's in the back, so it secures it to hold it, okay, so just go like that, and now you're good to wrap. And just keep wrapping. And you can, manipulate this open like this to be able to wrap easily. And you want it to be thick, so wrap generously and cover all of the cardboard completely. And you can do even two layers. Some people like their palm extra poofy and do three layers of wrapping. Okay, so I'm just going to wrap this all the way around just like this. And once I get to the other end, I'll show you how to start making our pom. All right, so I just wrapped this all the way around here. So now you want to make sure that you cut your yarn on this side, so the outer edge of the cardboard, just like that. And then we're going to take our yarn, we're going to hold this down flat, and then we're going to kind of separate the two pieces of cardboard, and we are going to pull a strand quite long, about 6 or 8 inches long, and pull that toward the center, and then have the rest of our yarn on this side, so like half and half, like this. And this is going to be our guide, and we are going to take our scissors in between the two and just cut along this edge. Okay, so this, we're going to wrap our pom with this. Okay, so that's just there to hold it in place, but you want to make sure that it's flat against the table so that it doesn't come going everywhere. And we are going to pull this as we go. And we're just going to cut. And it may seem a little difficult because the cardboard is tight together, but no worries, just be patient, and slowly but surely you will be able to cut your way through all the strands. And you can turn it and manipulate it so that you can access the yarn. And I'm cutting my cardboard as I'm saying this. So just cut all the way around and guide this strand as well with it to keep everything secure so that it doesn't, go crazy and all these little strands then get lost. And you want to be very careful with the scissors, obviously. You know, if you are trying to make a pom, make sure, you know, if children are making the pom with you, make sure you have adult supervision and be very cautious of the sharp scissors. And always keep your fingers out of the way. So I'm back to the beginning here. Okay, and now I'm going to cut this yarn like this. So now you can see here, this is our pom, and you can bring the two pieces together like this. And if you can see inside, that is what we're going to tie together in there. Okay, so tie a knot, okay, and if you can see in there, between the two, just pull as tight as you can, okay, and then tie it again. I got all kinds of cardboard in mine. Tie it as tight as you can. Oops. You want to make sure that this does not come off until you're ready, because we're going to loop it back to the other side and tie another knot. But you don't want your stragglers or little pieces to go all crazy on you and you can't see what you're doing. So that's the nice thing about an actual pom maker is that it doesn't do that. But I don't have one, so there we go. So let's tie it in two knots, one on each side. Then you can remove these pieces of cardboard and shake out your pom, make it all pretty. And you see these extra pieces here? We're just going to snip away at those and make it nice and pretty, kind of like landscaping here, our trees. So I'm just going to landscape this, and once I'm done, I'll show you how to attach it to our hat. Okay, so I just trimmed it a little bit, and I'm satisfied with how it looks. So we have this long strand here, and to attach this, we are going to attach it to the top of round row one here, or round one here. So what I'm going to do is just loop this around this way. Okay, and then loop this one around this way. Okay, and then from inside you want to pull really tight. Make sure that yours is secure. And then you want to tie a few knots. Just like that. And then yarn your needle. And then just go underneath the stitches to sew in that end. Just like this. And it might be a little difficult because it is really thick yarn. Okay. Stretch that out. There we go. And there you have your pom. Okay. Now we're going to make the braids on each side of our hat. So what we need to do is get strands. I already started one side, but get our three colors here, and we want 12 strands of yarn in total, and you want them to measure about 48 inches. So I usually just use my arm span, that's about 50 some inches, and I just do this until I have 12 strands of yarn. And you want them all to be the same length. Okay, and then cut the yarn and make sure each one is cut just like that. Okay, so once you have all your 12 strands, we can go on one side of our ear flap, right in the middle of it. And then what I like to do is just loop this around my hook and pull all the strands through, just like that. Okay, then you want to make sure that you even them out. So make sure they are even. And once they are even, you want to tie a knot. So wrap this around your hand like this, and then grab that. Almost like making a slip knot, except pulling all the way through. And pulling tight to secure that knot. And then we want to braid it. And to braid, we're going to take 8 strands of yarn in each hand here. 8 strands of yarn in each hand here, and we're just going to go over the middle strand, alternating sides. If you are unsure on how to braid, there are videos to show you how to braid that go slower and more in depth on braids, but I'm just going to braid down this side, and then I will braid down the other side. I'll show you at the end of this braid here. I'm almost done with it. This is such thick yarn that the braid is not very, it doesn't take very long to finish. So then once you get it to the length you want it to be, which I think this is pretty good, then you want to tie a knot exactly how we did the knot up here. So take your yarn, wrap it around your hand, pull that through, make sure all the strands are through, and pull tight. And we have a little straggler here that was left behind. Yep, see? When you do not get all the yarn and then one straggler is left behind, you make mistakes, and then you have to somehow get that yarn out of there by grabbing your hook and pulling it through. There we go. Okay. So pull it knot tight. And then once I'm finished with this side of the braid, I'm going to chop this yarn and make it all even all the way across on both. So make sure that this second braid is just as long as the other braid. And once I finish this braid, I will meet you up to finish our hat. Alright, so I just finished the braids. You want to make sure that before you tie off your second one, to make sure that they are the same length. And they are. And I tied them off. And now, to make sure that these are all even, just pick a length. Make sure that these knots are together. Pick a length you like. And get those scissors and start chopping. This chunky yarn is quite difficult to chop and try to, you know, make it work, make it all even. I was having difficulty with my palm earlier, trying to make it nice and uniform. Okay, there we go. So that is all even there. So there you have it, our chunky wavy hat. Just like that, with a pom on the top. Very lovely. So thank you so much for watching, and make sure to check out the links in the description of this video. You'll see, to get the link for the pattern for this hat. Now, I don't have other sizes for this hat, so this is the only size I have, but if you know how to do hats in multiples of 12, this is a multiples of 12, you could have ended on round 2 or 3 and just continued the patterns from row 5 on. So you can, you know, make it a variation of your own if you are experienced in crochet, but I do not have other sizes for this hat. This hat will fit any adult-sized person, woman or man. It's a unisex hat. So check out the link in the description to my blog, where it will have the written pattern for this hat. Check out also the links. There's a link to my Facebook. If you make this hat, please share a photo of it. I would love to see the colors you choose and also all your creativity. I love seeing all your photos. If you post a picture of this on Instagram, make sure to hashtag YarnUtopia or tag me in it. I'll put all my Instagram information on there. And check out my Snapchat as well. Follow me on Snapchat. I give like sneak peeks of behind the scenes kind of photos and videos of what I like to do in my off time when I'm not crocheting or when I am crocheting. And also check out my channel here on YouTube. Make sure you subscribe and check out my channel. On the right hand side, there is a button that says support us. Make sure you click that and support us so we can keep bringing you fantastic crochet videos. But thank you so much for watching today. Enjoy. Happy hooking.